conferences, you know, Evangelical Druki, the new moderator, but we have together with us today Irene Pataraki, the basic moderator of this group, the one who started the Creative Classroom group some years ago, to welcome you to the sixth Creative Classroom group and conference dedicated to climate change and environmental challenges. Irene, the floor is yours.
Hello, hello. I'm sorry for my camera, but the thing is that with this laptop, for some reason, I look huge. I don't know how to do with that. So, as I can see, I cannot be away from the Creative Classroom group, and I'm very happy to be here, and I will try to be most of the day here, because I had a look in the program, and I saw really interesting presentations.
I am again. Internet plays a big role these days for all of us teachers everywhere in Europe. So further to Narwas Latnia, Profesia, she's a Spanish teacher, eTwinning ambassador, mentor for new ambassadors, and she's going to talk to us about the climate change surrealist zoo. The floor is yours. Okay. You can open your microphone and your camera.
Okay, thanks. I'm just kidding. That I'm a moment. I must leave my car. Okay, thanks. Can you hear me? Yes. Okay, good morning, everyone. Thanks, Angeliki, for all the efforts you are making. Thanks, dear Irene. We really miss you on the group. So also, I would like to thank all the participants and attendees who are here with us in spite of this critical situation due to the coronavirus, but don't worry, we will rock. Okay, so I'm greeting you from Tunisia. I'm Najwa Satnia, teacher of Spanish, an eTwinning ambassador and eTwinning mentor for the new ambassadors in the last year. My presentation today is Climate Change Surrealist Zoo. It's an activity as part of the eTwinning Plus project Surrealist. For that, last, I would like to give you a brief overview about our project. The topic, just a moment, I will. Okay, so the topic is the Surrealism. That we are dealing in a multi-disciplinary way. In collaboration, we have done various activities in literacy, scientific, mathematical, plastic arts, and even in music and dance. We are seven schools from four countries, from Spain, Tunisia, Ukraine, and Bulgaria. And we are eight teachers. Amaya Alonso Cabria, me, Najwa Satnia, Olena Balova, Jose Antonio Sanchez Ojeda, Elena Alamanova, Aurea Garde, Anna Abartuta, and Rogelio Martinez de Loro, who are here following us in this conference. They sent me music in the morning to encourage me. I greet them. So, hola, queridos socios. Sois preciosos y me encanta colaborar con vosotros siempre. Bueno, gracias. Thanks. So, our project is in Spanish and in English. Okay. So, as you see, there are 155 students, partners, large number of participants, but in spite of that, we have well organized the tools and the activities that allow good communication and collaboration between them. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we move to the activity. Climate Change Surrealist Zoo is one of the important activities of our project. In this activity, we worked in the topic of climate change from an original and surrealist vision. So, as you know, we know all that climate change that the impacts of climate change are very negative in our planet. In this context, our students reflect about the climate change, about how climate change can affect animals and how these animals would be adapted to the five extreme environmental conditions that we propose. Then they collaborate together to create new animals, new species adapted to the climate. The result of this collaboration is Surrealist Zoo and online guide for this zoo. Okay? I can continue it, it's okay? Yes? Okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, so just firstly, I would like to explain the work process of our activity. To start, our students formed five mixed international groups. Each group, for example, Group Su, Erre, Ea, Li, Este. Each group, the names of the groups come from the title of our project, Surrealist. And each mixed group worked in one of the extreme environmental conditions. As you see, falls defrost, deserts at high temperature, coastal flooding, continuous fires, etc. Okay, so then for better understanding, we created a presentation, explanatory presentation by Geniali. And here we thank the efforts of our partner Amaya, teacher of biology. After that, our students worked in the forums, in five forums, one forum for each group, in order to communicate, to discuss, to agree the new Surrealist animals, and here I confirm that forums are very, the Twin Space forums are very, very important, useful for the collaboration and communication between students. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, after that, the collaboration was through the online tool, Google Drawings, so where our students create their animals. So each student adds a part of the animals in the document and explain in the forums its utility, why this animal needs these parts exactly. Then, of course, after we created 12 new Surrealist animals, 12 new species, and we need names for these animals, new animals. And for that, for example, the Tunisian students, as well as their partners from Spain, from Ukraine and Bulgaria, they proposed names. And in professional and scientific way, we need this name to be in Latin. And in this stage, our partner Rogelio De Loro, teacher of Latin, and his students helped us with the Latin name. So, as you can see, we have here 12 animals. Penguin cauda, ursus, serpentes escorpiones, camelus equus, planticus tigris, aurea, leonis draconis, caula berus, etc. So we learn Latin too. Okay. Thank you. Sorry for the attendees who can't see the presentation. Maybe it's a problem of connection or the Adobe. You can enter from the application Adobe Connect directly, not from the browser, please. Maybe. Okay. Okay, here you can see that our students are working together in the project. The motivation of our students helped us so much to achieve our objective in the in this activity. Exactly. So, the result of our good collaboration are two final products. So, online Surrealist Zoo. That you are all welcome to visit our online zoo. It's free. We use here the tool ArtSteps, and we create online Surrealist Zoo guide, a guide for this zoo to explain, to better explain the specific characteristic of the new animals. This explanation was in the forum of the five groups. Okay? So, here I'm really pleased and glad to present our 12 new surrealist animals. These animals that are adapted to the climate change. As you can see here, there are various new, etc. So we can say that our students are creators, inventors, and maybe we will think to file a patent for this invention to protect the intellectual property. Maybe, what do you think? Okay. And again, here you can see another animals, new animals created by our students. And now we can say that our new adapted animals can survive in this extreme environment condition of climate change that we are living now in the 21st century. And I want to end my presentation with what Charles Darwin said. It's not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent. It's the one that is the most adaptable to the change. And I think so. So, thank you. This is Climate Change Surrealist, our activity. That is a part of our project, H20 Plus Project Surrealist. I hope that you find it interesting. Thank you for your attention. Gracias. Shukran. This is.
Thank you very much, Nawa. Very interesting ideas, for sure. So let's adapt an animal. Why not? Only in twinning? No, we can do it as by ourselves. So yeah. I would like to.